हेलो गाइस, वेलकम एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल जेवीआर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल।
सो हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज 13.1। ओके, एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम सम नंबर 7। फॉर द प्रीवियस वन प्लीज चेक द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स, द लिंक विल बी देयर। So here in sum number 7, there are total 3 problems. First one, sum number 7a. In figure 1 given below, so first here you have to draw the figure. So this one here a square, okay, and this one a triangle. Just write the name, it's ECBAD, okay. So here equilateral triangle EBC, equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. Intersect each surmount square ABCD. Okay, so that means here ABCD square. So again, all sides are equal. Now find the angle BED represented by X. So first you have to join this one. So this one here X degree. Okay, you have to find out the value of this one. So as here EBC, triangle EBC is an equilateral triangle, that means all sides are equal. Okay, EB equal to BC equal to EC, and again ABCD is a square. Okay, so that means here AB is equal to AD equal to DC equal to BC. Okay, so that means here you can write down all sides are equal. The sides of the equilateral triangle is equal to the side of the square. Now here triangle ECD. Triangle ECD, here angle ECD equal to, you can write down angle BCD plus angle ECB. ECD ka angle jo aapke paas diya hua hai, angle BCD, that means this one, this angle. And angle ECB, ECB means that red one. Okay, so as here BCD is the angle of square, so definitely that one equal to 90 degree, and ECB is the angle of an equilateral triangle, so that one equal to 60 degree. So 90 plus 60, that one equal to 150 degree. Okay, that one equal to 150 degree. And as here triangle ECD is an isosceles triangle, because here EC is equal to with DC, that means here angle CED is equal to angle CDE, and that one equal to 180 minus 150 divided by 2. So that means here 30 by 2, it's 15. Okay, now here the whole angle BEC equal to 60 degree, because equilateral triangles angle. So that means here angle BED equal to 60 minus 15, and that one equal to 45 degree as your final answer. Now next one, sum number 7B. In the figure 2, so here you have to draw the figure. So this one a rectangle. Okay, so here it's a diagonal and extended up to E, C, D, B, A. Okay, that point equal to 0 or O, sorry, it's O, not 0. And this angle equal to 146 degree. Okay, so as here ABCD is a rectangle, diagonal intersect at O, AC is produced to E. If ECD equal to 146, find the angles of the triangle AOB. Okay, that means this one, and this one. You have to just find out the angles. Okay, so as here OE is a straight line. So this one equal to definitely 180 degree, the whole angle. So as the upper one equal to 146, so the lower one, that means here angle ACD, that one equal to 180 minus 146. Okay. And that one equal to here 34 degree. So as this one equal to 34 degree, this purple angle equal to 34 degree, then definitely this angle equal to also 34, because here AB, okay, AB parallel DC, AC transversal, so that means these two angles are alternative angles. So here angle OAB, that one equal to 34 degree. That is your first answer. Now the next one. So for the next one, you have to find out the angle OBA and also angle AOB. Okay. So here, this is a rectangle. This is a rectangle, and here AC and DB are the diagonal, and diagonals are bisect each other. So definitely OA is equal to OB. Okay, that means here in the triangle OAB, it's an isosceles triangle. So definitely angle OBA also 34 degree. Okay, so as these two angles are 34 degree, then definitely angle AOB is 180 minus 34 plus 34. Okay, so 34 plus 34, that is 68. So 180 minus 68, it's 112 degree as your final answer. Now the last one, some number 7C. So here ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, ABCD is a rhombus. ABCD. Here BD and AC are the diagonals intersect at O. If angle OAB, here is 2, angle OBA 3 is to 2. Then find the angles of the triangle AOD. That means this one, and this one. Okay, so OAB, OAB means this one, this purple one, it is OAB, and OBA, the another one, this purple one. So it's 3 is to 2. Okay, so that means here you can write down angle OAB equal to 3x degree and angle OBA equal to 2x degree. Okay, now you know that in the rhombus, okay, you know that in the rhombus two diagonals are bisect each other perpendicularly. That means this angle equal to 90 degree, the red one. So if this one equal to 90 degree, then you can write down here 3x plus 2x plus 90, that one equal to 180 in the triangle OAB. Okay, so here 5x equal to 90 degree, so x equal to here 18 degree. So as here x equal to 18, so this one equal to 3 into 18, it's 54, okay, 54 degree. And here it's 36 degree. Okay, so as here angle OAB equal to 54 and angle here OBA equal to 36. So here angle AOB equal to 90 degree, then definitely here you can find out this angle also 90 degree, this one. Okay, here angle AOD, angle AOD equal to also 90 degree. So now next thing you have to find out here angle OAD and also angle ODA. So now here you can write down angle OAD equal to 54 degree and angle ODA, that one equal to 36 degree. Okay, so these three are your answer. Now next, some number 8. In the figure 1 given below, ABCD is a trapezium. Okay, so here ABCD is a trapezium. So this angle equal to here 2x plus 10 degree. This one equal to here 92 degree. It's CD. These two lines are parallel. So here this one x plus 20 and this one here y. So you have to find out the value of x and y. Okay, so as here ABCD is a trapezium, so definitely you know that in the trapezium ABCD, angle B plus angle C, that one equal to 180 degree, as here AB parallel DC. So that means here Y plus 92, that one equal to here 180 degree. So Y equal to here 88 degree. So that is your first answer. Okay. Now, as well as you can also write down here X plus 20 plus 2X plus 10, that one equal to also 180 because AB parallel DC. So 3X plus 30, it's 180. So that means here 3x equal to 150. So x equal to here 50 degree. So y equal to 88, x equal to 50 as your answer. Now next one, sum number 8b. So here ABCD is an isosceles trapezium. Okay, ABCD is an isosceles. That means these two sides are equal. DC, this one parallel to AB. Okay. It's 2x, here 3x, it's y. Okay. So as here angle A plus angle D, that one equal to 180. So 2x plus 3x, that one equal to 180. That means here 5x equal to 180. So x equal to 36 degree. And as here AB, okay, AB parallel to DC. And AD is equal to BC. Okay, AD is equal to BC. That means here angle A plus angle C equal to 180 degree. Okay, angle A plus angle C, that one equal to 180 degree. So that means here you can write down 2x and here angle C it's y. So 180. So here y equal to 180 minus x means 36. So 2 into 30 is 72. So that one equal to here 108 degree. Now next one, sum number 8C. Okay, so here ABCD is a kite. Diagonals intersect at O if angle DAB 112, angle DCB 64. Find angle ODC and angle OBA. OBA, that means this one, this purple one, and angle ODC, that means this one, the red one. Okay. So as here AC diagonal of the ABCD, okay, so that means here angle DOC equal to 64 by 2 and it's 32 degree. Okay. Next angle here. Sorry, it's DCO, not DOC. Sorry for that one. It's DCO. Okay. Now, next one here, angle DOC equal to definitely 90 degree. So, you can easily find out angle ODC, that one 180 minus 90 plus 32. Okay. So, here your answer, it's 58 degree. That one equal to 58. Now, next. Angle OAB equal to half of 112, that means 56. Here angle AOB, that one equal to 90 degree. So again same process, angle ABO, it's 180 minus 90 plus 56 and that one equal to here 34 degree as your answer. Now next, sum number 9-1. Prove that each angle of a rectangle is 90 degree. Okay. So here, first here you have to draw a rectangle. So that one equal to here ABCD. Okay. ABCD is a rectangle. Now the opposite angles of a rectangle are equal. You know that. So that means here angle A is equal to angle C, angle D is equal to angle B. And you also know that in a quadrilateral, the sum of all angles, that one equal to 360. So here you can write down A plus B plus C plus D, that one equal to here 180. Okay. So now here angle A plus angle B. Now, in the place of angle C, you can write down angle A because A and C equal. In the place of angle D, you can write down B because D and B equal. So 2 into angle A plus angle B, that one equal to 180 degree. So that means here, if you divide by 2, so angle A plus angle B, that one equal to, sorry for that one, this one here 360, not 180. Extremely sorry for that one, it's 360. So here 360, so that means here 180. Okay, so now here angle A plus angle B, that one equal to 180 degree. And as here angle A and angle B, it's the angle of the rectangle, so definitely angle A or angle B, okay, or angle B equal to 90 degree. Now next one, sum number 9-2. If the angles of a quadrilateral are equal, prove that it is a rectangle. Okay, so in a quadrilateral ABCD, suppose here angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C equal to angle D. Okay, now here you have to prove that it is a rectangle. So as here angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. Okay, so here you can write down but here you can write down also here, these are the opposite angles of the quadrilateral. Okay, if you draw a quadrilateral here, suppose it's A, B, C, D. Okay, so A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. All angles are equal and also angles A and C are the opposite angle, which are equal. Angle D and angle B are also opposite angle, which are also equal. Okay, so as here the opposite angles are equal, that means here A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Okay, that means here you can write down A, B, C, D is a parallelogram as opposite angles are equal. But here angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D equal to 90 degree because sum of all angles equal to 360. So if you divide by 4, that one equal to here 90 degree. So as each and every angle equal to 90 degree, so you can write down here A, B, C, D is a rectangle and it's proved. Okay, now the third one. So here the third one, if the diagonals of a rhombus are equal, prove that it is a square. So diagonals of a rhombus. Okay, so that means here you can write down as A, B, C, D, just draw it. So BD and AC are the diagonals. So you have to prove ABCD is a square. Now here in the triangle ABC and in the triangle DCB, okay, ABC, this one, the purple one, and ADCB, the red one, okay, DCB, the red one. So here AB is equal to with DC because in a rhombus all sides are equal. Next, BC is the common side. And third one, you can write down AC is equal to BD. Okay, as two diagonals are equal, it's given. So that means here you can write down triangle ABC congruent with triangle DCB by SS rule. So here you can write down angle ABC is equal to angle DCB by CPCT. Okay, and also as here AB parallel to DC and BC here the transversal. So definitely these two angle, the addition of ABC plus DCB equal to 180 degree. So if these two angle are equal, then this one equal to here 90 degree. Okay, so as this angle equal 90 degree, so definitely it is a square. Okay, so you can write down ABCD is a square and it's proved. Now number 9-4, prove that every diagonal of a rhombus bisect the angle at the vertices. Okay, so here A, B, C, D is a rhombus, AC and BD are the diagonals. So first here you have to take triangle AOD and triangle COD. Clear? So from these two triangle, here AD is equal to CD, side of the rhombus are equal. Next here OD or DO is the common side, and next AO is equal to OC because the diagonals are bisect each other in rhombus. So here you can write down triangle AOD congruent with triangle COD. So if these two triangle congruent, then definitely this angle is equal to with this one. Okay, so that means here BD diagonal bisect the angle D. Okay, BD diagonal bisect the angle D. Now next one, here you can also prove in this way. Here the triangle AOB is equal to with triangle BOC. That means also this angle is equal to with this one. That means again BD diagonal bisect the angle P. Here we can write down the diagonal AC bisects angle A and C. Okay. And diagonal BD bisect angle B and D. It's proved. Now the last one, sum number 10. So guys, if you like my video, please share this video and please subscribe my channel. So here sum number 10, A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Okay, if the diagonal AC bisect angle A, then first you have to prove AC also bisect angle C. So here first you have to write down for number 1, AB parallel to CD. Okay, opposite side of the parallelogram. So that means here angle DCA equal to angle CAB. Similarly, you can write down here DAC is equal to here ACB. Okay, as AB parallel CD. Or for the second one, here AD parallel BC, the opposite side of the parallelogram. But as here AC bisect angle A, that means DAC is equal to CAB. DAC is equal to CAB. So that means here you can also write down this one as CAB. So therefore, angle ACB is equal to here DAC. Okay, so that means here AC also bisect angle C. It's proved. Okay, now number 2, ABCD is a rhombus. So as here AC bisect angle A and AC also bisect angle C, that means here angle A is equal to angle C. So that means ABCD is a rhombus. Now the last part is AC perpendicular BD. Okay, so as AC and BD are the diagonals of the rhombus, and you know that the diagonals of the rhombus bisect each other at right angles. So here you can write down for the third one, that is AC perpendicular on BD. So it's proved.